them bagger come can't taste me. Them bagger come can't taste me. Bad man, me a no say me a better than them. Them a call me yard, me a better than all. Bad man, me a never back down, stop. Them a mama got me a damn.
Hello, my love. Let's face the fact. We've all forgotten our toothbrush, toothpaste, and underwear at some point in our life during travels, right? No? Just me? Okay. Throughout my travels, there are so many mistakes I've made and there are so many tips that I've picked up along the way. And today I consider myself to be a mini expert on packing. If there is a job opening to pack bags, please, where can I apply? Let me know. Your girl wants to apply for a new job, okay? And here are my top 10 tips to pack light and efficiently. Oh, but before that, if this is the very first time you're watching me, hi, I'm Jumita. Welcome to my channel and please take a second to click subscribe to my channel. I want to share with you one of the most important and overlooked tips. Do a research on your destination. Check the weather. Is it cold? Is it hot? Is it gonna rain? Is it a modest country? It is a very good practice to pack your bag based on these information. Like to take a quick look at the local fashion Instagrammers before I travel, just to get an idea of the kind of clothes that they wear and what is acceptable there. Like, is it not okay to wear shorts? Are they wearing a lot of coats or are they holding umbrellas? These given a lot of clues to what you can expect during your trip. Tip number two, do your laundry at least 2 days before you start packing. This way you can make sure that your favorite pair of jeans, t-shirt or even underwear is ready to go for your travel. Now don't act like you don't have a favorite pair of travel underwear or jeans. Come on now. Tip number three, plan your activities in advance. Do not go blindly to a destination. Are you going to be hiking or trekking? Will you be going to fancy restaurants? Will you be going clubbing or doing a bunch of night outs? Will you be visiting churches or mosques? Because then you have to cover your shoulders and wear clothes that are below your knee. Take clothes accordingly. If you're gonna be going hiking, take your gym clothes, take a good pair of walking shoes. Night out definitely means a fancy pair of dress, a pair of heels, a nice clutch bag. You know the drill. Tip number four and the most important tip, make a packing list. Write down all the things that you want to take to your destination and start writing this list from when you decide to go on the destination. You don't have to stay till the very last minute, because sometimes we forget the smallest, silliest of things, like a pair of headphones or maybe a phone charger, maybe your underwear. Damn that underwear! Tip number five, plan your outfit. Back in the day, I used to just throw in a bunch of my favorite tops and a bunch of my favorite jeans into my luggage and call it packing. But then at the destination, I used to just go crazy trying to find a top that fit my bloated vacation self or find a pair of pants that matched a top that I took. It just didn't work and I was just always frustrated. So if you take just one extra hour to plan your entire set of outfits, top to bottom, including your accessories, hats, sunglasses, bags, shoes, whatever you want to go with the outfit, you will make sure that your outfit is on point every single day. Now, some people like to take pictures of this outfit and keep it on your phone so you have like a reference point, but I have a photographic memory, so I don't have to do that. Also, keeping in mind the number of days I have to travel, and I add in plus one outfit just in case something happens, I'm not comfortable, something spilled, you know. And I always like to throw in a pair of jeans and a pair of basic t-shirt for one of those days when you just probably don't want to dress up or just want jeans. And I also make it a point to wear the heaviest and the bulkiest item to the airport. So during winters, I'll be wearing the heavier jackets, and almost always you'll see me wearing my gym shoes or my bulky walking shoes at the airport. Tip number six, packing cubes. Now these are an essential in my travel life and I cannot pack without these packing cubes. I've showed you where I get my packing cubes in my recent haul video, so you can check it out right here. I categorize my outfits based on just tops or dresses and put them into one packing cube. Put my innerwears and pajamas maybe into another packing cube, depending on how many items I have, and you know, basically categorize things, put them into separate packing cubes. If there are multiple travelers, like for me, it's me and my husband, I can color code the packing cube. So have one color just for my packing cubes and another color for his packing cube. So at the destination, we don't have to rummage through the entire luggage to get our things out. If we want pajamas, we can can just take that cube out with the pajamas alone, take it, put it back inside. So no more messy luggage, because that seriously gives me anxiety, especially if you have multiple destinations. So at destination number one, you're taking things, putting it back, and at destination number two, you don't know where your things are anymore. And a lot of times what happens is you don't even end up using the things that you packed because you can't find them. You can also put the smaller items like your hair accessories into the smaller cubes, curling iron and other electronic cables and other things like that into another packing cube. You can organize everything into these little baggies or packing cubes. And you pretty much get them everywhere, guys. They're not even expensive. Tip number seven, travel sized containers. So you either transfer all your toiletries and skincare into travel sized containers, or buy travel sized little mini versions of your favorite skincare. This is also a very good time for you to use up all these store samples that you might have been collecting. I have a big drawer full of just sample sized products that I never use. So these are the ones that I take for my travels because they're already in tiny little sample sized containers. But if you have sensitive skin, it is best to stick to the products that you know work for you, so you don't have to experiment at a destination and risk your skin of breaking out or reacting in a bad way when you're on vacation. You don't want that. I like to save travel size containers so I don't have to buy them each time. You might think it's a lot easier to just carry your full-size shampoo and conditioner just as it is, but full-size shampoos, conditioners, toothpaste, moisturizers, night cream, that's a lot of things. They take a lot of space and they weigh a lot, guys. So if you can just transfer it into tiny little containers, your space is saved and your weight is saved. Another thing to keep in mind is that if you have any leaky liquids like oils or toners, put them into separate plastic Ziploc bags. So even if they explode mid-air or whatever, your whole entire toiletry bag will not be immersed in gooey liquid. Tip number eight, makeup. Carry products that can be used in multiple ways. For example, lipstick can be used as blush, and a pearly gold eyeshadow can be used as a highlighter. So might as well carry a big eyeshadow palette that has colors that can be used as your blush, your eyebrow product, your eyeliner, your highlighter. You can carry three or four lipsticks, a nude, a dark color, a red maybe, your eyeliner, mascara. Just carry the basics. You do not have to carry everything that you own. And also make sure that you carry products that are packaged in smaller, simpler packaging, because those don't take up a lot of space. And also make sure that you carry products that you don't mind damaging or losing. When you carry makeup, there is a chance that the makeup, especially powders, can shatter if you don't pack them really well, or sometimes because of mishandling by the staff members itself, because they throw luggages around, sometimes it can ruin your makeup. Tip number nine, shoes. I always carry neutral colors of shoes with me, like nudes, black or metallic, because these three colors look great and match with every single outfit. And the different styles of shoes that I usually carry are a pair of sandals, a pair of walking shoes, and sometimes a pair of heels. And usually they are just a pair of strappy black heels, because literally go with everything. When you pack shoes, make sure that you individually wrap both the shoe. Don't put them together and wrap them in a plastic and then put it in your bag, because they tend to be a little bit more bulky when they are put together. But if you separate them and wrap them in plastic or paper separately, you can actually shove them into little nooks and crannies of your suitcase, like wherever you can find space. So that's a huge tip. I've also seen a lot of people who throw in shoes just as it is into a luggage. I personally find that disgusting, because your shoes are on the ground, on the floor, so you do not want your shoes to come in contact with the inside of your luggage or your clothes or anything for that matter. So put them in a paper bag, or wrap it up with a newspaper or a plastic bag, wrap it up with something. And finally, tip number 10, taking care of your valuables. Your valuables, like your electronics, your cameras, chargers, your wallet, your passport, all of passport obviously, carry it in your carry-on bag, because when you put them in check-in luggage, you're still running a risk of losing them. When you have it in your carry-on bag, you have it with you at all times. Those are my top 10 tips to pack efficiently and lightly. Which was your favorite tip, and do you have any tip that you can share with the rest of our viewers? Comment down below and let us know. Thank you so much for joining me today. I really hope that you found this video helpful. Just in case you like my hair and you'd like to see a tutorial on this, you can click right here. And this makeup tutorial is live on my Instagram. I am feeling this look so much that this is all I've been wearing for the past couple of days. Yeah, so check out my Instagram for a mini toot. That's all, guys. I love you so much. Stay happy, and I'll see you on my Instagram.